Welcome to Angel Stadium here in Anaheim, California. Game two of a three-game set. As we welcome you to Mariner Baseball against the Angels this evening. And here come the Angels, led by their starter tonight, Garrett Richards, one of the bright young power right-handers in all of Major League Baseball. He's going to be a tough test for the Mariners this evening. Comes in with a record of 2-1 and a top fastball that the Mariners are going to have to deal with tonight. Here's a look at the Mariner batting order that will face Garrett Richards.
Lineup brought to you by Chevron. Leading off, it'll be Seth Smith. Seth with a home run in last night's ballgame. He's the DH leading off, and it's Ruggiano, Cano, Nelson Cruz, 14 home runs. That leads the American League. Then it's Seager, Logan Morris. In the last six games, hitting .435 with three home runs. Good sign for Logan and the Mariners. He will hit six. And Zanino, Ackley, and Chris Taylor rounding out the nine for the Mariners. Take a look at the numbers this year for Garrett Richards. 2-1 record, ERA right at 3 in 18 innings. He has 10 walks. Hopefully the Mariners can take advantage of that. He can get wild at times. 14 strikeouts, opponents hitting just 194 against Richards. And Seth Smith again going to lead off in a home run last night. It was the third run of the game. Mariners hitting three solo home runs. His home run turned out to be the difference as the Mariners went on to win 3-2. And we'll take a look at the defense for the Angels, brought to you by American Family Insurance. Cowgill getting the start in left field. Trout in center. Calhoun out in right. Freeze at third baseman. Ibar and Gia Vitella will play up the middle for the Angels. Albert Pujols, DH last night, back at first base this evening. And Carlos Perez will do the catching. Last start for Richards against the A's. He went six innings, just four hits, gave up one earned run. He had three walks in that one. Five strikeouts. He threw 103 pitches.
Well, here we go. Mariners win last night 3-2. Evens the season series at 2 and the road trip at 4-4. Wrap it up tomorrow. Off day Thursday. First pitch way outside for ball one.
Well, the guys are going to turn it up a notch. That first fastball, it was way outside, but it was at 97 miles an hour. With Smith hitting, the Angel put the shift on. So Ibar, the shortstop, swung around to the right side of the infield. Giovitella out on the grass.
1-1 to Seth Smith. Pops this one up. Coming on is Calgill. Got some room, and he makes the throw. One out. You look at Justin Ruggiano coming to bat. First time he'll be facing Garrett Richards.
Dave, I think it'll be interesting to watch in this game. We've talked about it a number of times through the first month of the season, but all the shifts that are going on, especially with the left-handers, I'll be curious to see how well that works for the Angels tonight. Richards, as we've talked about, good fastball. So far, every one of them has been 97 miles an hour, and it has a little run to it. You would think the lefties would hit the ball the other way a lot more, not because they're trying, but because they're going to have to. And the good fastball of Richards.
Home plate umpire for tonight's game, Greg Gibson, Marvin Hudson at first, Chad Fairchild at second, and Jim Joyce at third. One to one to Ruggiano. In there for strike two.
Justin didn't like it. You can see on our EQC tracer that pitch just off the inside corner.
Two. Richards turns 27 at the end of this month. Young man out of Edmond, Oklahoma. Born in Riverside, California. Breaking ball, strikes out Ruggiano, two away.
So difficult to lay off of this slider. It's 89 miles an hour right on the outside corner. And after you've seen 97 four times in a row in on your hands, it's going to be tough for the right-handers to stay off of that pitch.
Brings up Robinson Cano. Robbie, 0 for his last nine. He made a delightful double play last night in a backhand hard hit ball and a pirouette. That's going to get up the middle, and that breaks his 0-for. Cano first pitch swinging. is aboard for Nelson Cruz.
It's been interesting watching Cano. Over the last week, he typically has taken the first pitch till he gets a strike, and that's in every at-bat today. With Richards on the mound, he attacks that first pitch fastball right away. I think that's probably a good plan. You do not want to fall behind Richards, a lot like the Angels last night with Felix on the mound.
Well, here he is, the player of the month of April. Nelson Cruz all over the leaderboard in offense in the American League. And challenge there.
And it's much more than home runs.
340.
Yeah, 340 batting average. There you go. There's the list. Slugging percentage, extra bases, total bases.
And 340 is 10th in the American League batting average. And an 0-2 hold. Tied for second in hits with 35. Altuve leading with 40. Ellsbury, Jones, Fielder, and Cruz at 35. Richards has him 0-2. Well, that home run last night in the seventh, third time around against Shoemaker, 1-2 pitch. And as you mentioned, he fouled off a couple pitches right back.
He started to get on his fastball. Shoemaker pitched really well last night. He actually struck Cruz out the first two times, but you could tell on the swings he had finally had his timing right and was picking the ball up better. And Shoemaker had to pay a price for it. This wild pitch just spikes a breaking ball. Cano will get into second without a problem. And he had two strikes in that at bat when he hit the home run. We'll take a look at it. This ball landed out in front of home plate. Perez doing everything he can to try to keep it in front of him, but Cano being alert on the bases. We'll move down to second.
Perez making his major league debut, just called up from Salt Lake City. Came over in a trade from Houston. Highly regarded young catcher. Iannetta struggling mightily. This kid's going to get a lot of playing time. 1-2 to Cruz. High fly ball. Calhoun went back a couple of steps. And he makes the easy grab, and that'll do it for the Mariners. No runs, a hit, no errors, and a man left. Mariners nothing, and the Angels coming to bat against James Paxton. Paxton looking for his first win since last September. Let's take a look at the rest of his compadres.
Lineup for Mike Socia tonight. Following Calhoun, it will be Mike Trout. What a year he is having in his pool holes. David Fries, see what he's done against Paxton in his career. A 357 hitter with a couple of home runs, so Paxton will have to be careful with him tonight. Ivar Giavitella off to a good start. The second baseman, he will hit six, and it's Crone, Perez, and Calgill rounding out the 9 for the Angels. And for Paxton on the year, 5.74 ERA, looking for his first win. 26 strikeouts and 26 and two-thirds that he has worked. 8 walks. Opponents hitting just .268 against James. Take a look at the defensive setup for the Mariners tonight, brought to you by American Family Insurance. Ackley getting the start in left field. Ruggiano in center, Cruz in right. Kyle Seager, the third baseman. Taylor and Cano playing up the middle. Logan Morrison at first base, and Mike Zanino will do the catching.
So here we go with James Paxton. He's been improving in every start as we've moved along here. A line drive, base hit. Hard hit smash off the bat of Calhoun.
First pitch fastball, 93 miles an hour, right in the middle of the plate. James just trying to get ahead of the first hitter in the game, and Calhoun, being aggressive, lines it back up the middle.
Brings up Mike Trout. There are his numbers, 1-for-4, he's 2-for-13 against Paxton. And they're coming out aggressively attacking Paxton. First pitch swinging by Trout.
Well, that's one of the interesting things with James, and I thought it was one of the reasons why he was good against Houston. Houston was red hot when he faced them, but I think the thing about it is he was able to throw his curveball early in counts. He had to make an adjustment. He came out throwing fastballs, but he had the ability to do that, and he was able to settle into the ball game.
Fly ball right field, backing up Cruz. He's there for the out. Sixth start for Paxton, looking for his first win since last September 12th. Beat Oakland 4-2. He went 6 innings in that game. 4 hits, 2 runs, both earned, 3 walks and 8 Ks. Got one away and one on. And he'll face Albert Pujols. 2-for-14 with a homer against James. Couple of singles last evening for Albert. Mariners and these Angels start the day both at 7 games behind Houston in the American League West. Remember last year, Paxton came in here and threw a marvelous game against the Angels back on April 2nd. 7 innings, a 2-hit shutout ball, walk 2, struck out 9.
Well, as you look at the Angels, they have struggled offensively this year. The one guy in their lineup, we highlighted him, David Fries. He's basically the only one that's done much damage against Paxton. They'll have to be careful with him, Fries waiting on deck.
Remember last year, that was such an eye-opener, too. We were here to open the season, and Paxton pitched that game, and then his next start back home in Seattle. Got the victory against the Angels in a 5-inning stint. In that second game, Lloyd McClendon saw Paxton back on April 8th last year. That's when he suffered the lat injury. And we didn't see him again until August 2nd. 3-0 to Pujols. He was aggressive and drives it deep to left, and Ackley's going to watch it sail out of here. 2-run homer for Albert Pujols, his 5th, and RBI's 11 and 12 in a 2-0 lead for the Angels. Albert headed to the Hall of Fame. Oh, it really is something, even at this late stage in his career. 525th career home run. He's now 9 shy of tying Jimmy XX Fox for 17th all time.
Well, the difference in this at bat is Paxton missing with the first 3 fastballs. So Pujols was able to time those fastballs, and the last one was the only one he elevated. It was elevated middle in. And he always has the green light. You look at this Angels lineup, those hitters, 2, 3, and 4 that you have to worry about, Trout, Pujols, and Fries. Pujols gets the better of James with that at bat.
Second home run Albert's hit against Paxton. He's now 3-for-15. Two of the hits are home runs. David Freeze hits one hard. Ackley's right there. Two outs. Now bring up Eric Ibar. Ibar batting in the fifth hole this evening. He was the leadoff man in last night's Mariners 3-2 victory. Another first pitch swing. Cano didn't see it. Cruz closed ground nicely to help out his good buddy. And that'll do it. Two runs on two hits. No errors, nobody left. To the second inning we go. Angels with a 2-0 lead. Over the French back in 1862 as we look at most career strikeouts against this Angels franchise. Felix moving up on just about every list you want to compile in the American League. And good company there with Clemens, Burt, Mickey Lolich, Kitty Cott, and just ahead of Catfish Hunter and Sudden Sam McDowell. Great pitching names. Elite pitching names.
He was special again last night. Gave up the one solo home run, and that was on a 3-1 pitch that he just grooved for Joyce. It was because he had a two-run lead and didn't want to walk him. But outside of that, it was another great performance. 5-0 on the year for Felix.
First time he's been at that mark in his career. Here's Kyle Seager to lead things off. Looks at a strike. Seager, Logan Morrison, and Zanino, 5, 6, and 7 here in the second inning. Seager's good numbers against Richard, 6 for 19. Look out.
And there's more at-bats than anybody else in the lineup tonight with the 19 at-bats, but 6 for 19. A couple of RBIs against Richards.
I'm trying to remember, what was it, 2 years ago? Richards was breezing and then went away from his fastball, and the Mariners caught him late in the game.
Late. And he started throwing more breaking balls, and they were able to get to him. He has a good fastball going tonight, and I think he's going to make the guys prove that they can catch up to it. He's been 96-97 with some run to it. And like Paxton, he's downhill. Tall man. You're going to see him pitch down in the zone quite a bit in this one.
6-3, 2-10. He's working from the first base side of the rubber. Two and two to Seager's. Two for his last eight over the last two ball games. Nasty break to that one. Second strikeout for Richards. Some more great numbers for Mr. Hernandez. The against AL West rivals, fifth all-time against the Angels, third against the Rangers, sixth against the A's and against the Astros in limited appearances. Just their, what, third year division. Here's Logan Morrison. Saw Logan before the game. Dude, new bat, huh? I said, yep, rock bottom situation.
Been there.
Give me what you got. It was real simple. So
I give him a lot of credit. Go to the guy that's the hottest. Yeah. It's been Cruz.
So the number on the bat is a CB13LE, and it's a maple. He said, I'm telling him the next shipment. I want Nelson to order it for me, but just put Boomstick on it and leave it at that.
Hitters will do that from time to time. They have their own model, the weight that they want, the length of the bat that they want to use. But if they get into a rut or not feeling good, they'll go try somebody else's bat. And Morrison now swinging this heavier bat, hits this foul ball off of his foot.
So an inch longer, 2 ounces heavier. The advantage, explain that.
Well, I think the biggest thing is the 2 ounces heavier. Logan certainly can handle that. But I think when you get a heavier bat, you don't have to swing as hard. And if you get the barrel to it, it'll jump a little bit more. But you have to be able to handle it, the bat, not have the bat swing you. And that's been the biggest difference. And Logan's strong enough to do that. Most guys would not be able to go up 2 ounces on a bat and feel comfortable with it. And he did it again.
Jeez. So going up 2 ounces.
That's a lot. May not sound like it, but it is. And for these guys, they're so in tune with their equipment and what they're using every day, and 2 ounces for them is going to be a big difference. But obviously, there's more weight mass to that bat, and if you get the barrel to it, and we've seen Logan doing that. We showed the numbers, and he's starting to hit the ball out of the ballpark. And being an inch longer, create a little more leverage to it.
In the dirt, Mariners have hit 34 home runs, 27 of them solo. 12 consecutive have been solo home runs. They have 4 2-run homers and 2 3-run homers on the season. Reminds me of The Godfather. May your next home run be a 3-run homer. Remember Luca Brasi? May your next grandchild be a masculine child. That's not too shabby. Down into the corner. Going to go for extra bases, and he's going to get there. Logan Morrison on a 3-2 pitch doubles into the right field corner. That's his second two-base hit of the season.
And a really good at-bat. He ended up seeing 7 pitches in the at-bat, and he finally is able to get to a breaking ball. And he hits it hard down into the corner. You know, I think sometimes, too, when you go to a heavier bat, it looks like that's what Logan is doing. You don't feel that you need to generate as much bat speed. I'm just going to drop the barrel to it and let the bat do some of the work, and that's what he did on that swing.
One out base runner for Mike Zunino. Can't say enough about the great throw that he made to end last night's game to get Calgary. Who I'm told had a green light to steal. They tried to get it. Mike threw an absolute seed to Cano.
He had a good jump, too, to
he
steal
did,
it.
Yeah. Perfect throw. Cano right there on the spot.
I think with Rodney on the mound, I think for Calgill, he was hoping to guess right, and it was going to be on Rodney's changeup, not his fastball. But Rodney threw a fastball at 95 miles an hour, and I think that made up the difference.
Doing some talking around here. Brian is doing stats for us today. We're talking about, when's the last time you saw a game end like that? And we both were reminded of watching Ken Burns' baseball. The 1926 World Series, Game 7, Babe Ruth. Down a run, final out of the series, trying to steal second.
Really?
Yeah. Good bender there. That's the famous one where Grover Cleveland and Alexander had won the game before game six and comes out of the pen in game seven.
I think and a lot of people were asking me about Cal Gill running last night, and I think when you've struggled like the Angels have to score runs, you have a couple of outs. You're trying to bunch another two hits together off of Rodney when you struggled to begin with. I think they felt it was worth the chance to try to go. And if he had the green light to run, Dave, but Socia could have taken that off, too. He could have held him if he didn't want to. But I think, you know, when you're struggling, you try to be a little more aggressive, and it didn't work out for the Angels last night. But a great throw by Zunino, a clutch throw to end the game.
3-2 pitch to Mike. Fouled off. Another thing that was pointed out, when Rodney was here with the Angels, when he would come set, it would be his hands would be up a lot higher. Now he's a lot lower. And during that time, a lot of people were stealing bases on him, 18 out of 19. Since leaving, I'm told since leaving the Angels, Rodney has had 5 caught stealing against 17 stolen bases. With that slide step, he's really improved it, as you said, fastball. Mike Zunino, base hit, center field. Here comes Trout. Coming around third is Logan Morrison. Here comes the throw to home plate. It is not in time. And going to second base is Mike Zunino on the throw. So an RBI single by Zunino. And the Mariners are on the board. It's 2-1 Angels. Good hitting by Zunino on a 3-2 pitch. Picks up his 6th run batted in.
Well, Richard stayed in on his hands the entire time with the fastball. He threw one breaking ball for a strike. The rest of the pitches were fastballs. This is a fastball out over the plate. Trout has a good throwing arm, makes a good throw to home. But Logan had a great jump at second base, able to score on what was really a hard line drive into center field.
You got that front foot down. It wasn't up in the air. It was down and got plate contact. There's Dustin Ackley. Looks at ball one. Ackley 4-for-15 against Richards. Side from ball two, 2-0. Mike Trout upset with himself with the high throw. He had plenty on it. Ackley slashes away, comes up empty, 2-1. Exactly 2-for-13 on the road trip. And a 3-1 count. On deck is Chris Taylor. So popped up and playable. Ibar calls off freeze to make the catch. Route number two.
Shortstop number one, Chris Taylor.
Chris Taylor looking for a two-out RBI here. Chris batting in a 9-hole, his second game since being called back from Tacoma. Last night's game, a strikeout, a flyout to right, and a strikeout. Pitch to Chris. And he takes it outside for ball one.
Good news for the Mariners, along with scoring a run, coming right back and scoring a run, getting Paxton back in the game, as this next pitch will be 40 for Richards. The sooner you can get his pitch count up and get him out of the game, the better, I think. In his last outing, he threw 103 pitches against the Athletics. That was a season high.
This is pitch number 26 in the inning. way outside. Oakland leads at Minnesota 2-1, bottom of the eighth. Texas won at Houston 7-1. Wandy Rodriguez. Check that, they're winning 7-1, bottom eight. Wandy Rodriguez still pitching. There's Felix. He was real happy with his performance last night. So much improved from his previous outing against Texas. And popped up. Pujols has a play. And that'll do it. Mariners pick up a run on two hits. No errors. Leave them in. Get a 2-1 ball game here in Anaheim. Got it. 2-1 ball game. As Johnny Giovitella, second baseman, going to lead it off here in the second inning. It's our first trip to Anaheim. Second time we're seeing the Angels. We saw plenty of Howie Kendrick in L.A. with the Dodgers, but it's still so difficult for me to believe that he's no longer here.
I would agree with you.
That's one puzzling deal.
Well, things didn't change him being with the Dodgers.
Tell me about it. 1-2. Boy, he was murdered. Golly. Giovitella trying to fill Howie's shoes. Giovitella followed by C.J. Cron and Carlos Perez. Lomo's got to play. One out.
Take a look at the pitch selection for James Paxton on the season. He throws a lot of fastballs. I know Rick Wace wants to see him stay above that 65%. So 67% so far. Then the curveball, his changeup, he's throwing more. An occasional cutter from James. Typically he'll use that pitch to try to get in on the hands of the righty.
We're talking about how he's been trending upwards. What are big things that you've seen as he's now into his sixth start?
Well, I think, like any pitcher, his fastball command has been better.
Fly ball right field. Cruz is on the case. Two outs.
the other part is, and I talked to Rick Waits about this with James, he wanted to see him throw his curveball early in the count for strikes more often. James always has the hard 12-6 that he'll bounce off the plate to try to get hitters to swing and miss at it.
Right.
But he wanted to see it more, and we saw that in Houston. He was able to do that in Houston. Houston, a hot team, a team that likes to hit the ball out of the ballpark, and I think that keeps him off balance. And then the last thing, his velocity is finally back. That last fastball, he was able to throw at 95 miles an hour. So you put those things together, and you're starting to see the pitcher that we saw last year.
Carlos Perez making his big league debut at the dish here. From Valencia, Venezuela, same hometown as Felix Hernandez. Mike Socha, great catch himself. And there's the kid's first hit. He'll hold with a single as Ruggiano gets it back in, and they'll put that ball away. Take it out of play. Greg Gibson, all played umpire, out to get the ball from Paxton.
He's able to get on top of a fastball at 95 miles an hour, that fastball. Middle of the plate, right at the top of the strike zone.
Greg Gibson, very alert. Make sure he went out, got the kid's ball. Make sure he got it to the ball boy.
Well, it helps him being a catcher. I'm sure they've already had the conversation when the game started.
And just in case. Here's Colin Cowgill thrown out last night to end Mariners' 3-2 victory. Came on as a pinch runner. Two-one ball game. Albert Pujols green-lighted on a 3-0 pitch, hit a two-run homer, and then Mike Zunino singled in a run for the Mariners. Now 3-0, Cowgill. Left fielder tonight, batting in the nine hole and hitting 184. Four pitch walk to Cowgill. Two outs and two on. First girls' night out event of this year. It's set for this Friday when the Mariners are home to take on the Oakland Athletics. For just $35, you're going to get a view or terrace club seat, a great-looking Mariners cap, and your first drink. So visit mariners.com/girls for tickets. Top of the order in Cole Calhoun. First pitch swinging, single to center. Ball one. Angels' offensive profile this year, next to last in batting, 11th in runs, 13th in hits, 10th in homers. Just ahead of the Mariners in on-base percentage at number 14, 12th in steals and 5th in ERA. Paxton can't find the strike zone.
Well, Zunino, Rick Waits coming out of the dugout, going to make a trip to the mound. That's six balls in a row from Paxton, all of them fastballs. First pitch to Calhoun was his cut fastball, but the rest of them four seamers.
Wrap up this series tomorrow. Roenis Elias go against the veteran left-hander C.J. Wilson. Mariners will be off Thursday. Tywin Walker will open up the series against the Athletics against Sonny Gray. Saturday, Jay Happ against Jesse Hahn. Felix Sunday against Jesse Chavez. Two and oh here to Calhoun. There's a strike. Bottom of the order, having gone to work here for the Angels as they threaten. And Paxton will get out of it. So the Angels No runs on one hit, no errors. They leave two. To the third inning, we go on a 2-1. Dugout shooting that arrow in the sky. And this Saturday is Fernando Rodney Bobblehead Night presented by Root Sports. Mariners take on the A's, and the first 20,000 fans receive a collectible bobblehead of the arrow shooting closer. Get your tickets at Mariners.com.
Rodney getting the save in last night's ball game. Hopefully we'll see him again tonight.
Top of the order for the Mariners in the third, Seth Smith, Justin Ruggiano, and Robinson Cano. Fouled out to the left fielder, Calgill, to open up the ballgame.
Angels have the shift on again.
Broken bat pop up. It's in that triangle. Might be interesting. Oh, good closing speed by Cole Calhoun. One away.
Outfielders were playing deep. You can see Ibar, the shortstop, trying to find the ball, and then it'll be a basket catch by Calhoun.
One away here in the third. Brings up Justin Ruggiano, getting some time now on a regular basis with Austin Jackson out on the DL with an ankle injury. JR struck out on a 2-2 pitch his first time. He went deep last night in the sixth. Just missed hitting a home run. We figured a few grains off. It went straight up. Didn't get us enough carry
probably,
on it.
Probably just one. I mean, he took him back to the warning track. A towering fly ball.
Ooh, Jose Mota made a great catch on a foul ball last night. That to the right of the Spanish booth of the Angels.
He was prepared. He had his glove with him.
Yes, sir. Two and two. Run full. Richards has struck out two, not walked anybody. Giving up a run on three hits.
Cano waiting on deck. He had a base hit his first time up.
Perez sets up outside. The pitch popped up and no play for Pujols. Luciano part of the veteran bench that the Mariners have assembled this year. Counting Luciano, Richards has thrown a first pitch ball one to the last six hitters. And Luciano, he's aboard with a walk.
Second baseman, number 22.
Coming up tomorrow, our Century Link. What's next? Two lefties, Rowena Salias and C.J. Wilson. Wilson back in Seattle. Threw a complete one, eight innings in the Angels' 2-0 win over the Mariners back on the 7th of April.
One of the things that we've seen on this road trip is Ruggiano. He can steal a base for you.
Good series in Texas.
Yes.
Outside to Robbie. Luciano had a stolen base on Tuesday, April 28th. And had another one the day before. And in that game, he walked twice and scored twice. 1-1 to Cano. Bouncing ball that Giovitella handles. Takes the sure out. Luciano to second.
Two-way.
Except Cruz and fly it out to right on the 1-2 pitch. All the numbers we showed you during his first at bat, the categories in which he leads, he's also third road batting average. His first in extra base hits. I mentioned tied for second in hits. Pitch outside. Catches the corner for a strike. Leads the total bases. Swing and a miss, and Ruggiano will be able to advance to third.
We've seen Richards do this a couple of times, just spikes a breaking ball again. Went to flex off the arm of Perez.
Wild pitch. Ruggiano to third in this 2-1 Angel lead. Down low for ball one and two. Richards missed the last 8 weeks, knee injury last season. Angels are thrilled to have him back. Any significant difference or change since the last time the Mariners saw him?
I don't think so. I was wondering where Richards' fastball was going to be out, and everybody said that he was 95 to 97. We've seen that from him tonight.
2-2. Broken bat, fly ball, center field. Trout's got it, and that'll do it for the Mariners in the third. They strand Ruggiano at third base. And when Paxton comes back out, he'll get Trout, Pujols, and Freeze. early on. Mr. Pujols had a 3-0 count, Mike, and that's not an advantageous position to be in here for Mariner pitcher James Paxton.
No, you had to feel that he was going to have the green light, and James throws him a fastball up and in the middle of the plate, and he hit it out of the ballpark. For Pujols in his career, you can see why he has the green light. Great player, but on 3-0 pitches, he's hitting .442 with seven home runs.
Oh, man. I don't know anybody did that in wiffle ball, let alone up here. Jeez. Trout, Pujols, and Freeze. Drive to right, backing up Cruz. Makes the play.
Now, those are scary numbers.
Pujols with a home run, a two-run shot on a 3-0 count. Went for the high cheese and missed.
One of the better fastballs we've seen from James. 96 miles an hour at the top of the strike zone.
His great career. Pujols didn't like that, though. It was a little low, but put that bottom of the zone on it, too. 525 career home runs and 1,615 runs batted in. Good work inside. Couldn't get there. Paxton at a good pace. Breaking ball hit down to Seager. Backhands. Throws out Albert Pujols. Pujols ranking 18th all time in home runs. Stick around after the game for Mariners postgame presented by Delta Airlines. Two outs here in the third. Brings up David Freeze, the third baseman. Line out the left. Paxton a lot more sure of himself right now, being very aggressive.
Being very aggressive with his fastball, and he has a good one tonight. Starting to mix his changeup in a little bit.
Moving some feet too, which is a good sign.
There's the changeup again. Freeze out in front, barely getting a piece of it.
Quick two outs, now 2-2 to Freeze. Strike three called. Dropped another change on him. Goes 1-2-3 in the third. Mariners trail 2-1. brought to you by your local Ford stores. By Alaska Airlines. Enjoy free entertainment on your personal device. Learn more at alaskaair.com. By the Emerald Queen Casino. Welcoming Tower of Power June 6th. Tickets at emeraldqueen.com. And by Safeco Insurance. Find a local agent at safeco.com. Do more. Very comfortable night here in Anaheim, California. Game two of a three-game set with the Angels. First of three visits this season. 2-1 lead. Albert Pujols, a two-run homer in the first. Mike Zunino, a second-inning RBI double. Make that RBI single for the Mariners tally. Second time, Kyle Seager will lead off an inning. Struck out on a 2-2 pitch back in the second against Garrett Richards. All-star gold glove third baseman for the Mariners. Just two home runs at this stage. This one popped up. Fielder Calgill is there. Well, brings up Logan Morrison. Doubled into the right field corner. Momo extending his hitting streak to seven games. He's 11 for his last 24.
Really had a good at bat. Was able to foul off some tough pitches. Seven pitch at bat. He was finally able to get to a slider that he was able to hit down into the corner.
Fooled on that pitch. 0-1. Richards, a career mark of 3-1 and starts against the Mariners. 1.73 ERA. That pitch up high for ball. Well struck. Right center field. Trout not going to glove it. It's off the fence. Cuomo with a double with one out here in the fourth. Been rolling her up a whole bunch of those new boomsticks. He's getting it done. Two doubles tonight.
It is tough to hit a ball much harder than this one. He gets a fastball in the middle of the plate at 97 miles an hour. Turns it around. Screaming line drive off the padding out in right center field. So his second double here in the ball game. Hot.
Two for two night for the Lomo show. 12 for his last 25.
Zunino with a base hit. He drove in Morrison after his first double. Ended up getting a fastball out over the plate. Hit it hard into center field.
Quick one to Mike. A double by Morrison. Fourth hit by the Mariners this evening. Morrison has two. Double down right field line, and now that double off the fence out in right center. One, two to Mike. Mike with that RBI single in the second. Third, make that his fourth base hit on this road trip. Breaking ball, stays with it, fouls it away.
One of the few curveballs we've seen. He's basically stayed with a good fastball and the hard slider. That last pitch, 78 mile an hour curveball. We'll take a look at the pitch selection. Let's see, 56% cutters, only 4% curveballs, and he just threw one.
O2 pitch, fights it off. Giamatello will throw him out. Morrison to third, two away. improve on your business percentage and your bus percentage. Riding is easy. Just ask our rider's guide, available at soundtransit.org. Dustin Ackland popped up to short on a 3-1 pitch his first time. Tying run 90 feet away. Good block by Perez.
Logan, he needs to stay on his toes. Talking about the wild pitch last inning from Richards. Last year's wild pitch leaders in Major League Baseball, number one, Garrett Richards.
Mm-hmm.
22 wild pitches in 26 games. Felix was second with 18. Richards already with three this year.
Bouncing ball right to Pujols, take himself. That'll do it. No runs, a hit, no errors, and a man left. Romo having a good night, 2-for-2. Mariners trail, 2-1. All on Root Sports is brought to you by the Rockwood Fired Kitchen. Pizza, burgers, and spirits. By Vern Funk, bad luck can hit anyone. Insure with the 13th man. And by BNSF Railway, sponsor of the BNSF Blast. Hope to hear the old train signal tonight. The horn, let's hear it loud and clear. Maybe the Mariners will hit a few home runs. 2-1, a trail. As we go to the home fourth here for the Angels, Ibar, Giavitella, and C.J. Crone. Strike one to Ibar, flied out to right in his first at bat. Paxton picked up his first strikeout. That ended the third inning when he got Freeze looking. Another chopper off the plate.
Smart
play. Ibar hit one like that last night.
I think Kyle originally was going to try to field that and keep it fair, but Ibar is able to run well. Ball stayed in the air a little bit too long, so he decided to let it bounce and go foul.
Ibar, like many of the Angels, a very slow start, hitting 216 entering tonight's ballgame. Swing and a miss. He's gone. Back to back K's now for Paxton. 2-1 lead.
Last pitch. Good curveball from James. 82 miles an hour right at the bottom of the strike zone. It's an area that Ibar has struggled. You mentioned a slow start. Breaking ball, whether he's hitting left-handed or right-handed, at his back foot. He's having a tough time laying off of that pitch.
Giavitella fouled out to Logan Morrison at first base. Five in a row retired by Paxton. 1-1.
He's really had a good fastball tonight. That last fastball, 97 miles an hour. He's been 95 to 97 consistently tonight.
Two and one. Greg Wade's a pitching coach, keeping an eye on his lefty. Gone final. Texas 7, Houston 1. Oakland 2-1 winner at Minnesota. At 2 a final. Astros drop to 18-9. Texas improves to 10-16. Oakland improves to 12-16. Walk to Giovitella, second walk of the evening. One out base runner for the Angels. Hey, we have a very special King's Court set for Mother's Day this Sunday when the Mariners play host to the Athletics. For $40, you're going to get a seat in the court plus a limited edition pink T-shirt and K-card. Tickets will go fast, so visit Mariners.com/Felix today. Truly is one of the great experiences in baseball, being part of the King's Court, and everybody around the country has taken note. Houston King 5-0 for the first time in his career. Good ball game last night. 7 innings of 6-hit ball. 1 runner was earned. It was the home run by Matt Joyce in the 7th. 1 walk and 8 strikeouts and 102 pitches.
And I'll even give him a pass on the home run. He was up 2-0 and fell behind 3-1. And it was a few times he grooved a fastball. Joyce jumped on it, as he should. Felix, he's just been locked in.
Loves being in that stopper role. He played it to the max last night. 1-1. High fly ball, left field, got carry. Ackley running out of room at the fence, jumps, and
what
he makes
catch.
The catch. Dustin Ackley taking extra bases away from C.J. Crow. Terrific job there for out number 2.
Possible game saver. With Richards on the mound, he's throwing the ball extremely well. Perfectly timed jump by Dustin. Looks like maybe that might have hit the top padding, but a great play.
Giovitella had to scramble to get back to second base. 2 outs, man at second brings up Carlos Perez. Got a base hit to center field, the right center field, in his first major league at bat. That's a great job here. That looked like it was destined. Yeah, I was going to leave the yard. Ooh, maybe just short. He tracked that thing very well.
The main thing, and the thing that's hard sometimes, is to time your jump. It was perfect that time by Dustin. Well played. Mariners may have had their best defensive game of the year last night. They really played well.
Kind of clean game we've come to expect these last couple of years, and we've not seen that on a consistent basis so far this season.
You're right, and we were talking about it 4 or 5 days ago, and I just have all the confidence the guys were eventually going to get it cleaned up. And last night they really played well on the field.
Ground ball to Taylor. Makes it look easy. No runs, no hits, no errors, a man left. 4 in the books and a 2-1 Angel lead. we take a look at our Delta Airlines keep climbing standings. And this is updated with the Astros losing to the Rangers and the Athletics beating Minnesota. This is what you have.
You know, the Mariners right now looking to win this game, jump over the Angels, and they'll be right there with the A's.
Mariners 2-2 on the season against the Angels, 4-4 on this road trip. One more game tomorrow night. Here's a fly ball coming in hard. Calhoun, he makes the play. Off the bat of Chris Taylor, one down. Taylor 0-2 tonight, back to the top of the order, beginning the third time through. This will be Seth Smith. He's 0-2.
Couple of flyouts for Seth so far. And the Angels have the shift on. Richards has tried to pitch him inside with a good fastball.
So walk me through third time, your third time seeing the starter.
Well, the good news is you have his release point locked in. You have a real good idea of its velocity and how it is around the plate, the movement on his fastball. And you should be able to make an adjustment to it. Not sure if he had enough of it.
Calhoun backed up almost to the wall. Two outs.
So I think that Seth made that adjustment. He just ended up getting in on the barrel a little bit. He drives it back to the wall, but he was clearly looking for a fastball and was able to get to it at 95 miles an hour.
Quick two outs here in the fifth inning. Brings up Justin Ruggiano as Seth gave it a good ride. Got one out of here last night. See, they've asked all the fans to put on their Cinco de Mayo sombreros. What a picture. This is got to be 35, 40,000 here tonight. Fastball gets by Ruggiano. Outside. And Garrett Richards, 1-1. Both teams came into this series having been swept. You know about the Mariners at Houston. Angels were swept in San Francisco. Three-game series. Back up this way. JR, make a play. One and two to Ruggiano. Couldn't ask for a better opportunity with Jackson out injured. Ruggiano up and in, full count. Robinson Cano on deck. One hopper to freeze. That'll do it for the Mariners. They go down 1-2-3. Five consecutive hitters retired by Garrett Richards, who owns a 2-1 lead over James Paxton and the Mariners. He looked good for a couple of seconds. Colin Cowgill leads off here in the bottom of the fifth. Got a great sense of humor. 9-1 and 2 here for the Angels. Cowgill walked his first time up in four pitches in the second inning.
And he's quickly ahead here, 2-0.
Cowgill 0 for 5 against Paxton. Seager will take it. One out. Time now for a Geico this date in MLB history. Dan the Man, first career pinch hit home run. Seventh inning against Toronto. First homer of the season back in 2001. Feels like just yesterday.
Sure we'll get a chance to see Dan hopefully on the homestand.
Top of the order, here comes Cole Calhoun, third time. One for two. Single to center on the first pitch that he saw and scored on the Pujols two-run homer. That was in the first inning. 1-1. Two strikeouts, two walks tonight for Paxton. And that one knocked the mask off of Zunino. 1-1.
Greg Gibson, the home plate umpire, going to make a trip out to the mound to give Mike a little bit of time.
Well, the veteran guys get it. They totally understand it. Pats him on the back. Hang in there.
And more importantly, keep staying in front of the ball. Let it hit you.
Yeah, right? Good job! Two and one. Great defensive play by Ackley last inning, taking away extra bases from Crone. As Paxton pours in another strike, it's 2-2 to Calhoun. They hung one, paid for it, base hit the center. Two for three night for Cole Calhoun.
Oh, you're right. I think he wanted this pitch on the outer half and down. You can see Mike set up getting the glove low. But because he didn't get it down is the difference in that. That ball in the middle of the plate, maybe middle away as he hits it hard back up the middle. James hasn't made too many mistakes tonight. Really throwing the ball well.
First hit since Perez in the second inning. Four hits for both clubs. There's Trout, flied out twice to Cruz. Reigning MVP in the American League. Paxton behind 2-0. Trout leads the league or tied with Josh Donaldson for the league lead in run scores of 22 starting today. 10th in total bases. 4th in stolen bases with 6. Couldn't hold up.
And a good idea. Falling behind 2-0. Didn't give in to him with a fastball. He comes back with a changeup down, gets him to chase it.
Trout in the two hole. 5th in on base percentage, 8th in slugging. Three balls, one strike. Pujols on deck. Two-run homer for Albert and a ground out. His first three hitters pretty tough. Calhoun, Trout, Pujols. 3-1 pitch. 3-2.
Well, you can add Freeze to the mix, too, just because he has hit Paxton well. 67 pitches, 38 strikes for James.
Taylor and Cano, double play depth up the middle. Off-speed pitch. Strike three called. No objection by Trout. Third K by Paxton.
Pretty good 3-2 pitch. Comes back with a curveball. 81 miles an hour right in the middle of the plate. Trout was locked up.
Third strikeout for Paxton. And make sure you follow the Mariners all season long with MLB.com at bat, the number one app for live baseball. At bat is the up-to-the-moment with in-game highlights, live look-ins, replay reviews, radio broadcasts, StatCast, and more. Get MLB.com at bat for your smartphone or tablet. Gets away from Zunino. Calhoun's got good speed, makes a big turn at second.
That will be a wild pitch. This is the changeup. It's out in front of home plate.
So two outs, Calhoun, good wheels, he's at second. Stopped by Mike, 3-0.
Well, Pujols 3-0 count is when he hit the two-run homer. We mentioned it earlier. And they're just going to put him on. Probably not a bad idea. 3-0 counts in his career. He's hitting 442 with seven home runs.
That's an incredible stat.
Yeah.
Albert's only 18th all-time in home runs in the big leagues, too, with 525.
David Fries, 0 for 2. Fly out to left and a strikeout looking.
Intentional walk. It's a third pass issued by Paxton. Two out, two on. Big pitch, big at bat. Ball one and Zunino going after a couple words. Three strikeouts, three walks for Paxton. Two runs on four hits.
And Rick Waite's going to make a trip out now. Second time that Rick has been out to the mound in the game.
Rick is a tremendous communicator. Great rapport with all those guys. Paxton trying to get out of a two-out, two-on, fifth-inning situation with the Mariners down 2-1. One-oh pitch. Taylor right there. Boy, he hit it on the button. Frustrated, Freeze slams bat down. Mariners get out of fifth inning trouble and trail 2-1. brought to you by Steel. To find your local Steel dealer, visit steeldealer.com. By AMPM, too much good stuff. And by Honda. Get a dream deal on your favorite Honda now at your Honda dealer. Cinco de Mayo, they had set a Guinness Book of Records. Largest gathering with folks wearing sombreros tonight. 2-1 Mariners. Dave Sims, Mike Blowers, Root Sports crew here in Anaheim. Two-run homer by Albert Pujols in the first. Mike Zanino, an RBI double in the second, the only scoring. Here's Robinson Cano to lead it off against Garrett Richards. Outside to Robbie. Got a base hit in the center his first time up. Second time he grounded out the second. Cano, Cruz, and Seager, 3-4-5 for the Mariners.
Richards now at 80 pitches, still throwing hard. That last fastball, 96 miles an hour.
One pitch. Breaking ball, nasty. Good bite. 1-2. Robbie puts one in the gap. Out of the box hard and slams on the brakes as Trout gets it back in. Good start to the Mariners' sixth.
Right fielder, number 23, Nelson Cruz.
With Trout in center and Calhoun in right, they close the gap up in a hurry. Really good speed in the outfield for the Angels as Trout's able to cut this off, keep it from going to the wall. Cano thought about a double, but I think he made the right decision. It's a good throw back in by Trout.
All right, Cruz for the third time against Garrett Richards. Flied out to right, flied out to center. Bender for strike. Cruz counting tonight 2-for-13 against Richards. Side could catch up over 2. Not much of a lead by Cano. And could not catch that one as well. So Richard strikes out. Cruz on 3 pitches, 1-1. That's the third strikeout. And Garrett Richards 1-away in the 6th as we take a look at the Mariners calendar. Brought to you by Sleep Country USA. Wrap up this road trip tomorrow. A day off at home on Thursday. A's for 3. Another day off. What are you going to do, Mike? 2 days off. Come on.
Weather's supposed to be nice, too.
Then San Diego for a couple. Then the Boston Red Sox come to town. Here's Kyle Seager. Strike out and fly to left field. Strike one to Kyle. What do you think of this pitching rotation by the Angels? Richards, Santiago, Shoemaker, Weaver, who's down around 83 miles an hour now, and C.J. Wilson.
Well, I liked what I saw from Shoemaker last night, and C.J.'s off to a good start. His ERA is around 2.7. But I think you have to be concerned a little bit about Weaver with his fastball being down 83, 84 miles an hour.
0-2. Richards started tonight a 2-1 record of 3.00 ERA. So 2 here to Seager with Cano at first. Yeah, that's a wild pitch, and that's going to bounce all over. Cano will hold it second. He got him for three wild pitches tonight.
And it's on the slider. He tries to throw this slider as hard as he can, and that one actually hits the grass. It didn't even get to the dirt. How much of an opportunity for Perez, the catcher, to keep it in front of him.
Wild pitch in the first, third, and now the sixth.
Well, he led Major League Baseball in that category last year.
So one out, double play taken out of order. Cano in scoring position, and a 1-2 count to Seager.
Mariners so far tonight 1-for-7 with runners in scoring position, so they've had some opportunities off of Richards, but like the really good ones, they typically can pitch their way out of trouble. We've talked about Felix and the numbers. They just get better when runners get in scoring position. Felix is on the mound.
Short right field, long run, Giovitella, long run, Cole Calhoun. Giovitella makes the play. There's two outs. Two outs with Cano at second. And Logan Morrison swinging a very hot bat. Two doubles here tonight. This copyrighted telecast is presented by authority of the Seattle Mariners and may not be reproduced or retransmitted in any form. And the accounts and descriptions of this game may not be disseminated at the express written consent of the Seattle Mariners.
I wouldn't be surprised if they put him on right here. And that's what they're going to do, go to the righty-righty matchup. Zanino waiting on deck, and you can see Logan already 2-for-2 with two doubles. So even though he's the go-ahead run, they're going to put him on. It's one of the things that managers and the coaching staff will look at when you go into the series. Not just what your averages are, but who's the hot hitter. And Logan certainly is one of them.
Now this walk will be the first intentional walk, second walk of the ballgame for Richards against three strikeouts. He's also got three wild pitches. And here's ball four. Let's see what Zanino can do. Two outs, two on. Mike with an RBI single in the second. A ground out to Johnny Giovitella at second base in the fourth inning.
Well, he's driven in the only run for the Mariners, and he hit the ball hard back up the middle. It was on a fastball out over the plate. So we'll see how Richards wants to go at him.
Outfield straight away. Nino now with two career hits against Richards. He's 2-for-5. Oh, and hitting bases loaded. That will leave a mark. Leave it up to Ackley now with the bases loaded.
Mike was hit by a pitch in last night's ball game. Almost in the same area.
Got hit second inning.
Pitching coach Mike Butcher for the Angels out to the mound. A real good opportunity for Ackley to help his club out right here.
Boy, things can turn quickly and get some runs here.
Well, Richards now at 95 pitches again. His high this year is 103, and that was in his last start against the A's. Nobody throwing in the Angels' pen.
First time for everything. And if the Ack attack can put the Mariners in front. Ball one. Cano's at third. You got Logan Morrison at second. And Mike Zanino, he's at first. Two outs. So we play here in the top of the sixth. The 2-1 Angel lead. technically in charge right now, 2-0. Fastball?
I think it will be a fastball, and I think he needs to zone up in an area where he likes to hit the fastball. If it's not there, you just take it. 97 pitches for Richards. You want to go inside.
Gets the fastball and misses, 3-0. Uncomfortable and dissatisfied Angel fans making themselves heard. 2-1 ball game. Bases loaded, 3-0 to Ackley.
He's taking all the way.
Now he goes to work, 3-1.
Dustin likes the pitch up in the zone. Hopefully you get the same fastball. You can see that last one in the middle of the plate and elevated. He can handle that high fastball.
Here we go, 3-1. Takes it for strike two.
Oh, that one middle.
It all comes down to this. Two outs, bases loaded. Runners will be on the move. Richards ready. Pitch to Ackley. Strike three. Called. Inning over. Three. Stranded. Here's another look. Top half of this inning. Hey, this Mother's Day. Treat mom to an afternoon at the ballpark. Mariners will be hosting the A's this Sunday. The first 10,000 moms receive a Mariners sun hat, courtesy of EQC. For tickets to Mother's Day at Safeco Field, visit Mariners.com. Line drive. Down the line, foul off the bat of Eric Ibar. Ibar, Gia Vitella, and CJ Krohn, 5-6-7 here in the bottom of the sixth in Anaheim. Opportunity was golden for the Mariners top half of the inning. Six men to the plate, left the bases loaded. Opportunity passes him by. And tried. Greg Gibson looks like he's calling out Ibar, saying he's out of the box.
Did he step on the plate? Oh, he stepped out of the box, out in front of home plate and out of the box. Put out. We'll go to the catcher, Zanino. Are they saying he was out of the box? It's rare that you see that anymore. Take a look at his left foot. See if he walks up.
Boy.
That's close. Like I said, you rarely see it. You see him walk up.
On the line, for sure.
I think he's okay. A little break for the Mariners.
Take it.
To put out for Zanino, the catcher.
One away. Here's Diaventella. Found out Morrison at first and walked. Angels get their runs in the first. A two-run shot by Albert Pujols on a 3-0 pitch. Reggiano will take care of this. And the Mariners got their run. RBI single by Mike Zanino in the second inning. Quick two outs here in the sixth. And I bring up C.J. Crone. Crone took Ackley to the wall back in the fourth. Ackley made an outstanding catch. And again for Paxton, he's had a couple moments, but all in all, continues to trend in the right direction here.
I think he's thrown the ball well tonight. Misses with that changeup, but again, he's had a good fastball. He's been aggressive with it. He's straightened the hitters up enough, I think, tonight. At times, he's had a good curveball.
Long run for Cruz towards the line. Here comes Nelly. Makes the play.
He has more than acquitted himself in right field.
Agreed.
He's done a nice job. 2-1 Angels.
Got all of it. Two-run homer. And those are the two runs for the Angels to this point for Albert Pujols. Career home run number 525, RBI number 1615. Bill Krueger joins us right now. And Bill, want to get your thoughts on starting pitchers James Paxton and Garrett Richards and what they've done to this point.
And he throws that slider, Bill, as hard as you can throw it. And it's a tough pitch, especially to a right-handed hitter, as Chris Taylor just sees that one. Hey, Bill, on Paxton again, Looking at him, and you mentioned it with his velocity tonight, it had been down. It looks as if he's been building it up. How much of that do you think has to do with him missing time in spring training?
Got a good ball game here, Bill. Thanks so much for your insights on the pitchers. 2-1 ball game, top of the seventh. So Chris Taylor strikeout. Now back to the top of the order, Seth Smith, 0-3.
Angels have the shift on with Seth hitting.
Garrett Richards coming into this inning. 7-3 ball counts, 13 of 26 first pitch strikes. And the Mariners 1-for-9 runners in scoring position.
He's had a season high so far, 107 pitches. Fernando Salas getting loose in the pen for the Angels, but he's lost a little bit off of his fastball, but not much. He was topping out at 97. Right now he's more 95. Seth just missed hitting the ball out his last time up. He's able to take Calhoun to the wall and right. A pretty good swing on a fastball.
Seth Smith DHing tonight for the Mariners. Two pitch. Giovitella going back to his Ibar. Who's going to get it? It's Ibar. On the way. Make that two away, big point two.
Take a look at Ibar, over the shoulder catch. It's been a good one for the Angels for a long time now.
Two outs, nobody on, top seven. Justin Ruggiano 0-for-2 with a walk. Boy, he does snap that slider off hard, doesn't he?
He does, and it's tough as a right-hander. As Bill was talking about with his fastball, because he's effectively wild, I would call it, with his fastball. It's tough to stay in there on that slider, especially when he starts it at you like those two right there to Justin. As a hitter, you're getting geared up from 95 to 97 miles an hour and not sure where it's going to be. When he starts that slider at you, it's tough to hang in there. Three in a row.
High bar. Makes the play. 1-2-3. Go the Mariners in the seventh. Seventh inning stretch here in Anaheim in a 2-1 Angel lead.
mind as you consider how a Washington's lottery win would change your bucket list. Play today as we take a look at some time-lapse photography here. Anaheim, cloudy day. Felt like it was going to rain. Thank goodness it held off, but clouds most of the day here in Southern California. 64 degrees when we began this ball game, and clouds started going away as the Mariners started taking some batting practice. But then as we, the night advanced at 7:08 in the first pitch. And here's James Paxton still in the ball game in the seventh. He's got 8-9-1. Carlos Perez, the rookie catcher, fouls one off, strike one. Perez got his first big league hit. This is his debut, first base hit on an 0-2 pitch, two outs in the second. Second time up, he grounded out to short.
James is still in good shape with his pitch count. Only 82 pitches for him so far as he works here in the seventh. I'm sure that Richards' night is going to be finished. Good news for the Mariners. He was really good tonight. That's what we expected. We thought if James was on top of his game, we'd have a low-scoring game, and that's where we're at.
3-2 win last night behind the King. Felix Hernandez out pitching Matt Shoemaker. The pitch misses away. 3-1.
The Mariners, in fact, have had more opportunities than the Angels. The Angels 0-2 with runners in scoring position. All the scoring coming on a two-run homer by Pujols in the first.
Here's a drive to left center field. Ackley got a good beat on it. Makes the catch. Dustin Ackley, his second outstanding defensive play in left field. Went up against the wall to take extra bases away from C.J. Cron in the fourth.
Well, first and foremost, he gets a good jump on it, and then his route was perfect. Solid line drive by Perez in left center field. Ackley able to run it down.
1 out brings up Colin Cowgill, walking a ground out tonight. Speedy outfielder shows bunt, takes a strike. Cano makes it look easy. Got a nice hop, too. Two away. Take a look at the Big Fish Casino big catch. Mike, this is a beauty here back in the fourth.
This is a well-timed jump up against the fence with a runner on base. Dustin goes back to the wall. We weren't sure if he was able to catch it or not, but he does. Not sure if it would have gone out, maybe hit the top of the padding, but it would have been trouble for the Mariners and Paxton. Fine play by Ackley.
Cole Calhoun, 2-for-3 night. Single to center, comebacker to Paxton, and a single to center. That was in the fifth.
Good fastball from Paxton, 96 miles an hour.
It's a great sign here in the seventh. Strike two. Paxton tonight struck out three and walked three. Took a lot off and strikes out Calhoun. Well done. 1-2-3. And Paxton retired the last seven men that he faced as we get a good look from the blimp. A 2-1 Angel lead. Sports being brought to you by Money Tree. Proud to make a donation to Mariners Care for every Mariners win. By Jack in the Box. Jack's hottest sandwich is back. Head to Jack in the Box for Jack's blazing chicken sandwich. By CenturyLink, your link to what's next. And by Geico, 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance. Here in Anaheim, Angels with a 2-1 lead, middle game of a three-game set. Mariners with a 4-4 record on this road trip, 2-2 against the Angels. And aerial coverage provided by Goodyear. Everything Goodyear has learned, making tires that go the distance, inspires what they roll into yours. Goodyear, more driven as we look at you from the Spirit of America out of Carson, California, home base about a half hour north on the 405 from Anaheim.
Good opportunity for the Mariners here in the eighth inning. Richards is finished. He's over with. Now you have Smith, the sidearm reliever. He has pitched well for the Angels. This will be his 12th appearance, a 1.69 ERA, 12 strikeouts in the 10 and two-thirds. Opponent sitting 268. He has yet to give up a home run, but it's the middle of the lineup for the Mariners. Cano, Cruz, and Seager due up. Cano already with two hits.
Cano 1-for-9 against Joe Smith. Robbie drives one. Long run, Trout. Not going to get it. One hop the fence. Robinson Cano, a leadoff double here in the eighth inning. For Robbie, his 10th two-bagger this season.
He has hit the ball hard tonight. Last one was in right center. This one over Trout's head. It is not easy to hit a ball over Mike Trout's head in center field. This is on the line as it bounces off the fence. A good start for the Mariners with Cruz due up.
Nice work by Robinson Cano. Check that. He was 1-for-5, now 2-for-6. It's Cruz who's 1-for-9 against Joe Smith. Nelly tonight, 0-for-3, two flyouts and a strikeout. Mariners have left seven men on base tonight, five for the Angels.
1-for-9 with runners in scoring position.
No one. Bruce didn't like that. 1-2. Greg Gibson, home plate umpire tonight. Two. Back up here. An opportunity to tie it up or even take the lead here with the boomstick at the plate. Cano a leadoff double. And dropped by the catcher, Perez. Perez catches a break.
The first pitch fastball, and since then it's been the breaking ball. Joe Smith, his breaking ball. Well, his fastball, he's not overpowering. He's going to be in the upper 80s, 87 to 88, maybe 89 at times. His slider, right around 82.
Now he can run, freeze, throws, and gets it. Cano to third. Gets your job done. Chance for Seager to tie it up.
You see Freeze, he's playing deep. So fine play, he'll come in and barehand this ball, throws a strike to first. But Cano will move up to third. Field will be in for the Angels.
Mm-hmm.
Seager 0 for 2 against Joe. One away. Tying run at third. Strike one to Kyle. Tie ball game. Kyle Seager with a clutch base hit. RBI number 13 for Kyle. Now you bring up Lomo, a hot hitter. 2 for 2 with an intentional walk.
Hey, look at Kyle. Takes the first pitch breaking ball, and then Smith tries to sneak a fastball by him. And with the infield drawn in, Kyle able to hit it through the right side.
Marson bounces it foul, strike one. Marson's doubled into the right field corner and doubled to right center. Off the fence. Farquhar heating up for the Mariners. Lomo hits it hard, center field, base hit. What a night, 3 for 3 for the big fella. Moving up to second is Kyle Seager.
And he is hitting everything on the button right now. It's a fastball down and away and hits it hard back up the middle. We had a double down the right field line, a double in the right center gap, and now that base hit back up the middle. Mike Zunino has driven in a run tonight. Mike 1 for 2. He drove in the first run for the Mariners.
Coming back in a second inning. Since then, he's grounded out the second and was hit by a pitch to load the bases in the sixth. Ball one. Zunino looking for his first hit against Joe Smith. He's 0 for 5. Count even at one. Longest tenured manager in the big leagues, Mike Socha. A lot of room out there for Zunino, 2-1. It's foul. Two balls, two strikes to Mike Zunino.
So Danny Farquhar getting loose for the Mariners. Fernando Salas, the right-hander, getting loose in the pen for the Angels.
Joe Smith on in relief of Garrett Richards. Long look for Perez. Now he's ready. 2-2 pitch. Full count. First and second, one out in a tie ball game at 2-2. You got Seager at second and Morrison at first. Time's called. Nino hits a long way, right field. One hop into the stands for a ground rule double.
gives the Mariners the lead as Kyle Seager scores. Great job by Mike Zunino. 3-2 Mariners.
Mike driving in his second run of the ball game. We saw him hit a home run in Houston on a pitch that was on the outside corner. And he hit it into the seats. And this is good hitting again. Smith mixing it up with his slider and fastball. This is a fastball down and away from him. Doesn't try to pull it. Hits it down into the corner. It'll bounce over the fence. It's a shorter wall out there. So ground rule double. And Mike Socha out to the dugout.
So the Mariners get into the bullpen and chase Joe Smith. They take the lead 3-2 here in the eighth inning. Seager and Zunino, 3-2 Mariners in the eighth. And hey, kids, be part of the Cano Show this Sunday at Safeco Field. All kids receive a set of Robinson Cano wristbands courtesy of Aquafina. Join us for the Mariners A's game and get a great-looking pair of Robbie Cano wristbands. For tickets, visit Mariners.com. How about Mike Zunino? Two really good moments here on this road trip going the opposite way.
Oh, I would agree. A couple of good pitches, too. Mike driving in a couple of runs tonight.
Fernando Salas takes over. We've got Zunino at second. Morrison at third. And another run scoring opportunity for Ackley. Left the bases loaded, taking a called third strike. Back in the sixth.
Still just one out, so the Angels will bring their infield in again. They had the infield in when Seager was hitting. He picked up a base hit to right. Drive in a run and tie this game up for Salas this year. 4.76 ERA, 10 strikeouts and 11 to 30. He's only walked two batters. Opponents hitting 267. He's given up a home run.
Opportunity again for Ackley. This time 2-1. The looper. Left field. Cal Gill runs it down. Morrison coming home and he will score. 4-2 Mariners. And he did not leave too soon as the Angels appeal at third. So Ackley put it in play. Heck of a catch by Colin Cowgill.
I thought Dustin had a chance to dump that in for a base hit. Cowgill has a good throwing arm. Take a look at it. Flared down the line. He covered a lot of ground to get to it. Strong throw to home, but it's offline. Now the Mariners go up by two.
So three-run inning, holding at second. And Zunino, chance for Chris Taylor to get his first RBI of the season. He was called up yesterday. Late inning lightning by the Mariners here in the eighth. Ibarz there, throws out Taylor. But a fine inning by the Mariners as they score three times to take a 4-2 lead.
Six outs to go. Danny Farquhar is going to get the first opportunity here as the Mariners score three runs on four hits. James Paxton has a chance to win a ballgame.
Really good outing for him. He hung in there. He gave up the two runs that you can see earned on a two-run homer by Pujols in the first inning. Three walks for him. He only gave up four hits. He threw 91 pitches. Strong outing for Paxton, topping out at 97 miles an hour. Danny Farquhar will take over his 12th appearance on the year. ERA just over four. 11 strikeouts and 13 in the third. Opponents hitting 245 off of Danny. Good fastball. He'll be in the mid to low 90s. Also use a cutter around 90 miles an hour, 12-6 curveball. He's going to get the tough part of the lineup. It'll be Trout, Pujols, and Freeze due up here in the bottom of the eighth.
Here we go. Big inning for the Mariners. RBIs by Seager, Zanino, and Ackley. Ackley getting his first RBI without benefit of the home run. It's his fourth RBI. Here's Trout. Mike 2-for-5 against Farquhar. Trout tonight, two flyouts to right and a strikeout looking. Andy coming in, and he's behind 3-0.
Charlie Furbush getting loose out in the pen.
Back in it at 3-1.
That's Charlie.
Playable. Logan Morris in foul territory. One out. Good battle by Danny Farquhar. Down 3-0. Comes back and gets a pop. Brings up Albert Pujols. 2-for-5 against Farquhar. Pujols tonight homered on a 3-0 pitch in the first inning. Two-run shot, then grounded out to third and was intentionally passed in the fifth inning. Strike one, Albert.
Good curveball from Danny.
It's going to strap in for a base hit. Come on, blooper.
up David Freese.
Good fastball, 93 miles an hour on the inside corner. Jams Pools, but he'll pick up his second base hit of the evening. He's been on base now three times. Had the home run, grounded out the third, a walk, and now that base hit.
Brings up Freese, lined out hard to Kyle Seager at third to end the fifth inning. Prior to that, a fly to left and took a cold third strike. Double play opportunity here for the Mariners. Count at 1-1. Anderson battled back. They trail 2-1 through seven. They put up a three spot in the top of the eighth. 1-1. Cruz will take a look. He's got no play. 1-2 to Freeze.
Danny likes to throw his cutter. And with Freeze, the one thing we know about him is tremendous power to right center field. He tries to keep the ball in tight on him.
Angels battling here, two runs, five hits. They've left five. The Mariners, four runs, nine hits. They've left eight. Pitch. Great job by Zunino.
How did he catch that?
Mariners can get a win here. They'll pick up the game on Houston. Astros lost 7-1 at home to Texas. That's a great play.
You can see how far in front of home plate that ball hit. He ends up catching it.
Two-two pitch. Count runs full here. Eric Ibar's on deck. Ibar 0-for-3 this evening. Big pitch here for Farquhar. Lost it. Tying runs are aboard. Go ahead, run coming to the plate. One McClendon and company trying to go 5-4 in this road trip. One more game tomorrow, so Charlie Furbush is ready. Ibar switch hitter. One for four against Danny Farquhar, who can really use a double play ground ball.
Mariners defense straight up on the infield and the outfield.
All one.
Danny's struggling with his command right now. 14 pitches, just six strikes from him.
Swing and a miss, 1-1. 1-1, one out. Runners at first and second in this 4-2 ball game, bottom eight.
Taylor Featherston has come on a pinch run. A little pinch run for Freeze at first base.
Missed away. And he needs a ground ball right at somebody. 2-1. Didn't get it through the hole. Pujols coming around. Cruz will throw to third. It's cut off. We got a 4-3 ball game as Ibar comes through with his ninth run batted in. Pujols scoring from second.
We'll take a look at it. He gets a fastball, a little cut fastball, 88 miles an hour at the top of the strike zone. Cruz makes the right play here. You're up a couple of runs. He has a strong throwing arm. I'm sure he thought about maybe trying to cut down Pujols at the plate, but he does the right thing. Get the ball back into the infield. Keep the double play in order. You do have the tying run now at third. And Lloyd McClendon coming out of the dugout. I hope he's going to have a conversation
with Danny. Charlie Burbush, the left-hander, has been getting loose in the pen. Giovitella, the righty, due up. So I don't think he's going to make a change here. I think he just wants to talk to Danny. He needs a ground ball to get out of this inning.
It certainly does.
Ground ball, double play.
And Gibson going out to break up the cut bed. Giovitella fouled out the first, walk and fly to center. Then he got the first out on a foul out, then gave up a base hit, walked Freeze on a 3-2 pitch. Ibar beat him on a base hit to right to score a run on a 2-1 pitch. A one-run ball game, 4-3. And runners at the corners. Tell his numbers against Danny Farquhar. Strike one. Dominic Leone joining Furbush out there in the bullpen for the Mariners. One pitch. Pitch out, nothing doing. Mariners were trailing 2-1. Put up three in the top of the eighth, and now the Angels have a run on the board here in the bottom of the eighth. A threat for more with one out, runners at the corners. Pitch from Farquhar. Through the hole, base hit, tie ball game. Got two ground balls, but they both found holes.
And with Giovitella hitting, Kyle Seager had to play up at third. Take a look at it. Looks like a cut fastball, and it is. Good look at our Alaska Supermo and the cutter off the end of the bat. Both Kyle and Chris Taylor, you can see where Kyle's playing, trying to keep the ball on the infield.
Tie ball game. Paxton cannot win it now. To the back step, and Cole gets the double play. Ted too late, but it's a tie ball game as we go to the ninth. Here in Anaheim, and the one that was critical was Giovitella's eluded the dive of Seager and Taylor.
ninth inning here in Anaheim. In the third inning, Mariners, in the eighth inning, Mariners look good with a three spot on the board. And they got some timely hitting.
With the infield in, Kyle Seager gets a base hit. Cano led the inning off with a double. He'll drive him in, tie the game up. And then Mike Zunino going down the right field line, a ground rule double. He will put the Mariners ahead as Seager scores.
And how about Ackley put it in play down the left field line. Calgill makes a nice catch. Throw offline. Morrison scores. The Mariners with three runs to take the lead and then gave it right back in the bottom half of the inning. And Houston Street always tough when the Mariners takes over.
He's really pitched well. 9 for 9 in save opportunities. This is not that type ball game. His ERA right at 1. 10 strikeouts in the 9 innings that he has pitched. He has walked 3 batters. Opponents hitting just 156, and he has yet to give up a home run. He will deal with the top of the order for the Mariners. It'll be Smith, Ruggiano, and Cano due up.
Houston Street's had a terrific career. 36-29. A 2.79 ERA, and he's got 284 career saves.
Angels with the shift on, Seth Smith hitting.
Ball one to Seth, his fifth plate appearance, 0-4 tonight.
Houston, not your typical closer. He is not going to throw 95 miles an hour. Be 87 to 90 miles an hour with a slider. Change speeds on his fastball. Try to keep it on the ground if he can, but he'll do a lot of that. Pitch right on the edges of the plate.
And nobody moves around on the rubber more than he does. Two and one to Smith. Hung up there for Smith, drives it to left center field. It's caught easily by Mike Trout in the way. Ruggiano will swing the bat now. He's 0-1 career against Street. Tonight, Justin is 0-3 with a walk and a strikeout. Been with Oakland. He was with them from 05 to 08. Colorado 09 into the 11th season. San Diego 12, 13 and part of last year. And he joined this Angels ball club. One pitch. Foul off one and two. Nice work by James Paxton tonight. 7 innings of 4 hit ball, 2 runs, both earned, 3 walks, and 4 strikeouts.
It's a shame that he will not factor in the decision now. Mariners scoring those 3 runs in the 8th inning put him in line to get his first win.
All 2 strikes. Strike 3 called. Ruggiano got it away. CenturyLink, what's next? Couple of lefties tomorrow. Roenis Elias against C.J. Wilson. Wilson beat the Mariners earlier this season back in Seattle.
Dominic Leone getting loose in the pen, so he'll pitch in the bottom of the ninth inning. Cano's having a good night. Hit the ball hard. 3-for-4 tonight, including a double, and he scored a run.
Cano 1-for-9 against Houston Street. There you have it.
1-0 pitch. 2-0. Mariners' first run coming in the second inning. Mike Zunino drove that in. Seager, Zunino, and Ackley with RBIs in the eighth. Backing up Trout. Stays in the yard. And two steps onto the track. Mariners go 1-2-3, top nine. We're going to see Dominic Leon, Perez, Calgill, and Calhoun coming up. Sees their third hurler this evening. Tie ball game, bottom of the ninth inning.
For Leon on the year's eighth appearance, a 4.32 ERA. Opponent's hitting just 219 off of Dominic. Good fastball in the mid-90s. Will throw a slider. They will get the bottom of the order for the Angels. It'll be Perez, Calgill, and then back up top, Calhoun, the leadoff hitter, batting third.
Carlos Perez in his major league debut. First at bat on an 0-2 pitch. He singled to center for his first base hit since then. Ground out and a line out to left center field.
Charlie Furbush continues to throw in the Mariner pen. A couple of left-handers on the bench. Navarro and Joyce available to Socha if he wants to pinch hit him.
High fly ball deep left field. And this ball game is over. How about Carlos Perez in his first major league ball game? It's a game-winning home run in the ninth inning to break the Mariners' hearts 5-4. Goodness gracious. Talk about storybook. Talk about storybook.
Looked as if he ended up getting a breaking ball that was up and in the middle of the plate. And Dominic did not get away with it.
Well, highly regarded, Carlos Perez, and that is some major league debut. Bottom of the ninth inning, a game winner. Carlos Perez's first major league home run. And oh, baby, that was hanging up there, and he was all over it. So the Mariners on this road trip drop to 4-5 with the finale tomorrow. Series even at 1-1. They're 2-3 on the season against these Angels, and an opportunity to pick up a game on Houston goes by the wayside.
We'll take another look at it. Breaking ball up in the zone, and he did not miss it as he hits it out into the bullpen. Alaska Supermo just spinning.
That is impressive for a kid to come up. He came up yesterday. Chris Iannetta has been struggling mightily. They're happy to see this youngster come up here and dividends immediately on Cinco de Mayo. 5-4 the final. Mariners postgame presented by Delta Airlines starts right now with Angie and Bill.